What's up guys, my name is Dean, aka The Blue Crusader, and welcome back to the channel. We've covered the top 10 Christmas games and the top 10 Christmas horror games this month, which you can check out after this video, and we've even covered the top 10 Minecraft Christmas mods and maps too. In this video, I'll be talking about the top 10 best Christmas events in games. These games bring Christmas-fueled holiday seasonal events to the game with awesome missions and quests that offer brand new loot and surprises for the players to acquire. Without further ado, let's get into the video. Number 10, RuneScape Winter Event. One of the most popular and well-known MMORPG games of all time, RuneScape actually has a set of different winter and Christmas themed events every year, which tend to slightly change every Christmas. These events are a little different to each other and cover the winter season. Firstly, there's the Winter Event, which usually takes place in January after the Christmas season. 2020 had the Windtumber Warmer, which was from the 2nd of January to the 6th of January 2020, with a 10% experience boost for non-Iron Man mode players in the area, and it had Poi Dancing, Fire Breathing, Lantern Building, and Spirit Summoning events. When players logged into the event, they could teleport to the area as they were greeted with a special login message. The Christmas event is also super special in RuneScape. The 2020 event consisted of various Christmas activities throughout December 2020, and the current event for this year at the time of making this video started only merely a few days ago on the 14th of December, including various activities and a huge giant Christmas cracker located at Varrock's Grand Exchange. Players who log in will see a message stating, "Help Santa build his giant Christmas cracker at the Grand Exchange so that it can be opened for rewards." During skilling, players can earn 20 to 30 Christmas cracker paper every 3 minutes, which work as the currency that's added to the in-game currency pouch to spend. There's a lot of stuff to do, and you can even wear snowboards during this event. Number 9, Overwatch Winter Wonderland. Overwatch's annual Winter Wonderland event is a seasonal Christmas event every year that's running from December the 15th to January the 5th this year. This event usually includes two new cooperative brawl modes, Maze Snowball Offensive and Maze Yeti Hunt, which take place across Christmas-themed reskins of the pre-existing maps in the game. Along with this, the event brings winter reskins of maps Hanamura and King's Row, with 12 special limited edition achievements, along with some special items and loot boxes only unlockable during the special event. In the previous years, players were given 5 loot boxes entirely free to celebrate the game's crazy success. This year, there's brand new skins Conductor Reinhardt, Ice Empress Moira, or Penguin May, as this Snowball Deathmatch, Yeti Hunter, and the Snowball Offensive Brawls as well, as also a new Freeze Thaw Elimination playstyle. The event has weekly challenges which require you to win games in quick play, competitive or arcade, in exchange for getting sprays, player icons and festive skins for free, like Elf Junkrat, Gingerbread Anna and Frosty Roadhog, which will make sense for people who actually play Overwatch. Number 8, 25 Days of Smite. Smite Battle of the Gods is a game based upon mythology in which you can play hundreds of different god champions inspired by the various multiple cultures around the world, from ancient Egypt to voodoo-inspired gods. Each year, Hi-Rez release a Christmas update, which usually spans over a different series of days, with this year's being the 25 Days of Smite, an advent calendar-themed event that spans across 25 days of the month, each having different bonuses up until Christmas Day. Many of these days bring multiple worshippers or battle points and favor bonuses in the game, or free chests or just percentages off of the chest purchases in the in-game store to make things a little bit cheaper. Number 7, Elder Scrolls Online New Life Festival. Beginning on December the 17th and spanning till January the 5th, the Elder Scrolls Online's New Life Festival is an in-game event and celebration of cross-culture that can be started by the quest that the in-game store gives. During this year's event, you can unlock 10 special daily quests set all across the continent of Elder Scrolls, as well as another quest line. Completing these quests grant you a gift box which contain many different types of clothing and cosmetics, and even some pets like a snowball buddy too. Although it's not strictly a Christmas themed event per se, it's inspired by the holidays and it's the winter event that runs on the game throughout December in the Christmas season. Number 6, Dead by Daylight Winter Solstice. Dead by Daylight is a fast-paced multiplayer survival action horror game where one player plays the killer and the others are a group of survivors that must complete the various challenges within the level and escape from the killer following them. This game actually has a seasonal event called Winter Solstice, and although it doesn't come every year, it's one that's worth noting to play at Christmas time if it's out on that specific year, and if you love the blend of horror and Christmas themes coming together. The two Winter Solstice events so far ran from 2017 to 2018, and are events in the game that usually last from December to January, and are in-game celebrations of Christmas that usually bring new winter-themed menus, new props to the map like snow piles, snowmen, lanterns, and also an overhaul of certain lighting and fog effects, as well as the introduction of various new holiday music themes to the game. Sometimes there's even new modes like 2018's Blood Hunt mode that's a reoccurring holiday event that gives bonuses to the blood point gains in-game. Some more notable additions are customizable items for the survivor characters, like new Christmas jumpers or chilling glowing blue frosty eye effects for some of the killers in the game. Number 5, Destiny 2 The Dawning. Free for all players of Destiny 2, The Dawning is a special time of the year in-game that functions as the game's Christmas event that's taken a different form over the years since it began. From December the 15th till January the 5th, this year's event lets you discover a new recipe, open a few brand new gifts, and take a trip somewhere new in your ship. There's all new seasonal vendors and rewards that await you during the event, with the ability to earn Dawning Spirit by completing the various missions, bounties, and recipes during the event span. The more spirit that you acquire, the better rewards that will be in store for you to get. Number 4, Killing Floor 1 and 2. The Killing Floor games are some of the most popular multiplayer zombie type games on Steam, and they've been around for years now and are definitely some of my favourite games in the genre. The first thing I'm going to take note of is Killing Floor's free DLC mod called Killing Floor Toymaster, which you can get on Steam for the first game. Now, this isn't strictly a Christmas themed mod, but I feel like toys and Christmas just go hand in hand, and it makes sense to play. Basically, this lets you fight off strange and bizarre toys from someone's warped nightmare, where all of the standard Zed mutants are now replaced by new evil toys in a brand new Devil's Dollhouse map. What screams Christmas horror more than fighting off waves of corrupted toys during the holidays? Now, this is for the same reason as Killing Floor 1, as they both have really great Christmas events, although Killing Floor 2 is slightly newer and the content is a little bit better and more up to date, which is why I'm going to focus on the Christmas event for this one and not any kind of DLC like I did for the first game, which I mentioned previously. Every year there's always a Christmas themed event on this game, with this New Year's Christmas Crackdown event being the one to play right now. Basically, this update brings a flurry of new cosmetic items for customizing your characters, like evil Zed mutants on your backpack which have Christmas hats on, new seasonal objectives and challenges to play to get new rewards from, and it also changes the Zed mutants into Christmas horror themed creatures, like new evil gingerbread men, giant mutated reindeer monstrosities, toy robots, and nutcrackers. There's a new community-based map this year called Elysium, and a ton of new content to explore, which is why you should play the badass Santa character in the game and smash through some waves of mutants this Christmas. Number 3, Team Fortress 2 Swissmas. Valve's Team Fortress 2 brings an event each year since 2013 called Swissmas, the name for the TF2 Christmas events. Although Christmas events on Team Fortress 2 have actually spanned back since 2010. Swissmas 2020 is a major update that dropped on the 3rd of December this year, and adds various brand new items to the game, as well as 4 brand new Christmas themed maps that Valve hand selected from the community creators on the Steam Workshop for their high quality. This update brings 20 all new cosmetic items, 13 new war paints, 8 new taunts, 19 new unusual effects, and more, like a stuffed stocking as a gift for the players who log in during the event. This year's event runs till January the 7th, which gives you plenty of time to play the 4 new maps, Pier and Vautville, which run on the payload cart pushing game mode, Snowfall, which is a capture the flag map, and also Snowville, which is a player destruction map. Number 2, World of Warcraft Feast of Wintervale. Blizzard runs possibly the biggest MMORPG of all time, World of Warcraft. Although I haven't played the game in quite some time, one thing I always looked forward to was the annual Christmas event, the Feast of Wintervale, which is the festive time of the year in-game, which lets players throw snowballs, eat festive treats and other foods, and get holiday gifts. In the place of Santa Claus, there's the dwarf Great Father Winter, and you'll head on brand new quests like saving stolen reindeer or defeating bosses and getting their treats as rewards. Usually during this event, there's also decorations in the game's cities of Orgrimmar and Ironforge, where the core of the event is hosted for both factions of the Horde and the Alliance. There's a lot of toys, pets, collectibles, and more to acquire during the event, and the game feels so much warmer when many of the NPC characters are wearing Christmas elf-themed outfits. Number 1, Apex Legends Holiday Bash. Apex Legends is undoubtedly my favourite Battle Royale game right now. Although I've taken a short break from it for a few weeks whilst the current season comes to an end, I made sure to hop on and finish the challenges for this year's seasonal event, Holiday Bash, which first started last year. Beginning on December the 1st of this month, you can already hop on and play the mode on Steam or Origin. There's a myriad of Christmas frosty themed new skins for many of the Legend characters and for the in-game weapons that you can buy, as well as all new challenges to achieve in matches to level up and get the skins and rewards from the event, which are free. The best part of this event is the limited time mode Winter Express. This lets you play as any of your unlocked legends, with each having a rotated, fixed class with different weapons to choose from that changes every single day. Basically, the train stops at each station around the world's edge map, and each team must battle to capture and control the center cart of the train to win each round, with the final team standing on the cart or surviving being able to win it. This is an action-packed seasonal mode on one of my favorite games. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, and if you think I missed your favourite Christmas event in a video game, then definitely let me know about any other Christmas events in games in the comments section below, and tell me which of these 10 Christmas game events were your favourite and why. For more top 10 videos, subscribe and turn on notifications. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.